Beast appeals, describing the woman as 5 feet, 3 inches tall and weighing about 100 pounds. She was last seen wearing pink running clothes. A mystery donor, operating outside the family and the police, initially offered $50,000 ransom, £40,000, for the mum's safe return. The ransom was then doubled to $100,000, £80,000, before the offer was pulled the day before Sherri was found. What happened next? After 3 long weeks, Sherri was found, 150 miles from where she first went missing. The mother flagged down a passing motorist at 4:30 a.m. on Thursday, November 24, in Sacramento. Her husband Keith shared his horror at seeing his wife's serious injuries. In a statement to U.S. media, he said, "Nothing could have prepared me for what I was about to see upon my arrival at the hospital, nor the details of the true hell I was about to hear. The mental prison I was in over the past 3 weeks was shattered when my questions of my wife's reality became known. The officers warned me to brace myself. My first sight was my wife in a hospital bed, her face covered in bruises ranging from yellow to black because of repeated beatings, the bridge of her nose broken. Her now emaciated body of 87 pounds was covered in multicolored bruises, severe burns, red rashes and chain markings. Her signature long blonde hair had been chopped off. She has been branded, and I could feel the rise of her scabs under my fingers." He said that his wife had been thrown from a car with a chain around her waist and with a bag over her head, saying she had suffered both intense physical agony and severe mental torture. The tortured woman has since told police she had been thrown from a dark-colored SUV by her captors, whom she described as 2 Hispanic women armed with a handgun. What have police said? Police have since said they did not expect details of the kidnapping to be released, particularly details that the woman had been branded in the ordeal. Head of investigations at the Shasta County Sheriff's Office, Lieutenant Anthony Bertain, said, "There's some unique information in there that was in his press release today that we were hoping to keep a tight rein on as far as what we were going to release to the public. It's not the first hurdle in this investigation that we've had, we've overcome many of them, not just in this case, but there's surprises in all investigations, so this just wasn't good timing." Police have previously said they were deliberately holding back information around the investigation.